Welcome back. This lesson is on the affective domain. Now, the affective domain, as I have mentioned previously, deals with feelings or emotions, and it could also be dealing with interpersonal relationships. In simple terms, it deals with attitude. Now, there are 5 different levels within the affective domain, and these are receiving phenomena, responding to phenomena, valuing, organization, and internalizing values or characterization. So we will just look at the descriptors for each of these levels in brief. So receiving phenomena refers to the willingness to hear or to have selected attention or awareness about something, and in that sense be open to receiving some external information. Responding to phenomena is where the learner manifests active participation, attends and reacts to a particular phenomenon. Valuing is the worth or value that one attaches to a particular object or behavior, and this could range from either a simple acceptance to commitment. And organization is where the learner organizes these values into priorities by contrasting different values, resolving conflicts between them, and creating a unique value system. Internalizing values or characterization is when the learner has a value system that controls his or her behavior. Now, this may sound a lot confusing and vague. I hope the illustrative examples will clarify this for you. So what are the action verbs here? So receiving is follows, gives, holds, sits, etc. Responding, you have words like answers, discusses, presents, writes, tells, performs. Valuing is follows, initiates, reports, differentiates. Organization is integrates, modifies, synthesizes, combines, completes, formulates, defends. Internalizing is practices, proposes, displays, influences, and so on. As in previous videos, you would have realized that some of these words are repeated. And that merely is a reflection of the fact that the rest of these words in the context would have a bearing on whether it falls within a particular level or not. So let's look at an example here. Let's suppose you are considering physical activity as the phenomenon or behavior. So your scenario is that you are organizing a session on physical activity, and so each level the statements are about a learner who manifests the characteristics of that particular level. So a person who is in the receiving level would listen attentively in the session. When this person asks questions about evidence favoring physical activity, that is an example of responding. Now, the person is impressed with the information provided, and when the person discusses the importance of physical activity with colleagues, it indicates valuing. The person then prioritizes physical activity enough to make fitness activities a part of his or her schedule. That's an example of organization. And when the person of his or her own volition conducts workshops or seminars on fitness, then that's an example of internalizing. So I'm not entirely sure that this makes sense to you on the first glance. I would encourage you to review what has been covered in this video, and a few Viewings of the video may help clarify these levels within the affective domain. So that's about the affective domain. See you in the next.